Hi, in this video I will be talking about bitwise operator. Okay, so before I start the topic, let's see the two important term that is called as operator and operand. See, suppose there is an expression saying a plus b is equal to c. A plus b is equal to c. Here a, b and c, the variables that you have, those are called as operands. The values on which we perform some operation, they are called as operands. And plus, the symbol that denotes what operation needs to be performed on an operand, these are called as operators. For example, if I have a minus b equal to c, there a, b, c is the operand and minus is the operator. So we have seen different operators. In this video, we will be talking about bitwise operators. See the definition. Okay, the operators that are used to manipulate the bits of the given data is called as bitwise operator. Till now, what we were doing is we directly used to have the numbers and we used to work on it. Okay, something like 10 plus 20 is equal to 30. Now what we do is we have a number, we work on that number by converting that number into binary form. That means something that the machine understands, and the machine only understands 0 and 1. So here we will be working on the data which is in the form of 0 and 1. And see the different types of operators we have. We have negate operator, left shift operator, right shift operator and XOR and OR. Okay, so I'll discuss each one of them in detail. Okay, let's start with negate operator. See here, the operator that is used to change every bit from 0 to 1 and 1 to 0 in the specified operand is called ones complement or negate operator. That means when you have 0 and you apply negate operation, negate means like not, like opposite. So if you have 0, it would give 1, and if it is 1, it would give 0. Okay, let's learn this with the help of an example. Okay. Okay, this is negate. This one is negate. Okay, let me show with the help of an example. So let's say, let a is equal to 10. What is negate of a? So I'll show you this in the form of different steps. Step 1 is convert the number into binary. Convert the number into binary. So you have a is equal to 10. 10 is decimal number. So you have to convert this into binary. So how you will convert it into binary? You have to divide that by 2. Okay. So something like this. See, 2 and 10. So 2 times 5 is 10. Okay. Here what you will write is, you will write the quotient, put a dash, and then you will write the remainder. Remainder is 0. Okay. Again you will divide. So 2 and 5. So 2 times 2 is 4 minus, you'll get the value as 1. So write the quotient towards the left and the remainder towards the right. Like that, again you do. Okay, so I have got 1 as a quotient, 0 as a remainder. Now if you see very carefully, you can't divide 1 by 2, right? So you will leave it as it is. You will leave it here. And the answer will start from the bottom and go towards the top. So your answer is 1010. This is your binary form of the number 10. But the thing is, note this, okay, when we write numbers in binary form, okay, we usually write it in 8 bits. So what I will do is, see this answer, the answer is only having 4 bits, so I will add 4 more numbers. We can't do anything because the answer should be unaltered. So what I'm doing is, I'm adding 4 zeros at the start. Okay, so this is how I will convert the given number into binary. Okay, let me erase this Okay, so I hope you have understood the first step. The first step is whatever number you have to convert that into binary, and you can do that by dividing the number by 2. Okay, now step number 2. Carry out the negate operation. This is step 2. Okay, you carry out the negate operation. Carry out negate operation. How do you do it? You write the numbers. A is 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. This is your A. You have to find negate of A. That is, you have to write the opposite. So, if it is 0, it is 1. And if it is 1, it is 0. So, I am filling it. This is the answer. Okay. So, you have got the number in the negate form. But then this number again is in the binary form. So, we are not able to understand. So, what you are supposed to do in step 3 is, step 3, you have to convert that number back into decimal so that we humans can understand it easily. So, convert into decimal. Decimal. Okay. Convert it into decimal. So, the number I have is 1 1 1 1 0 1 0 1. This is my number. Now you have to convert it into decimal. You will do this by writing the values, okay, that which value it is a power of 2. So something like, you know, 2 to the power of 0. You have to start at 2 to the power of 0. What is 2 to the power of 0? It is 1. Like that, you have to write the next power. So 2 to the power of 1. 2 to the power of 1 is 2. Then 2 to the power of 2. 4, then 2 to the power of 3, 2 to the power of 4, 2 to the power of 5, 2 to the power of 6, and 2 to the power of 7. Like this, you're going to write. Now, one more thing you have to notice. Okay, see here. This particular bit, the leftmost bit, this is called as highest significant bit. This is the most or the highest significant bit. And this is the least significant bit. Least significant bit. This is called as most significant bit. Okay. So, the left one is called as most significant bit. And this is called as, the right one is called as the least significant bit. Now, remember this. When you have the most significant bit value as 1, that means your given binary number is a negative binary number. So, what you're supposed to do is, you have 128 over here, right? You put a minus sign over here. Okay. So, for example, if I have something like this. Let me write. 4 zeros. 1 second. Okay. So, I was saying that when you have numbers like this, okay, see, so the numbers look something like this. 1 minute. Okay, so the number is going to look like 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 1 0 1 0. If the numbers look like this. So, here this is the most significant bit and this is the least significant bit. So, when you are writing 128 over here, you will see the value of the most significant bit. And you see that the value is 0. So, you have to keep it as 128 itself. And you have to do the normal operation. Whereas in this side, the right side one, our problem, we are having the most significant bit as 1. So, we are putting minus sign over here. Now, you have to multiply these two. You have to multiply the binary value with the powers of the 2 and then you have to add and write the answer. So, it is 1 times minus 128, which is 128 itself, plus 1 times 64, so 64 plus 1 times 32 plus 1 times 16 plus 0 times 8, which is 0, and 1 times 4, 4, and this is 0, and this is 1. So you will get the answer as minus 11. Okay, so this is the value. So if A is equal to 10, not of A is minus 11. This is how you will carry out the negate operation. I hope you have understood. So you can take up some examples and you can try doing that. Okay, next one is, next operator that we have is left shift operator. Okay. Under bitwise, we have the next type, that is your left shift operator. Left shift operator. Let me write its general form first. Okay. So, it will be something like this. Okay. This is the general form. This is the symbol for left shift. Okay. For example, if I have let A is equal to 50. Okay. What is B, which is A left shift 1. That means you will shift the values of A to the left by one place. That is what it means. Let's solve this. So step 1. You know the step 1 because the numbers are in the decimal form. First thing you have to do is convert the numbers into binary. So converting it into binary. Okay. So convert into binary. Okay, you will convert it into binary, so you will divide it by 2. So 2 7 times 14, because that's 14 is the nearest number, so the remainder is 1. Again 2 3 times, remainder 1. 2 1 times, remainder is 1. So you have got the value, so you will write it. And I had told you that for negate operation also, if you don't have 8 numbers, then you have to add zeros. So I am adding 4 zeros. Then we have the number here. We will go like this. So it is 1, 1, 1 and 1. Okay. This is the number you have got. Now you have to shift it one bit towards the left. Okay. Now you will actually do the shifting operation. Okay, you will carry out the left shift. Okay, so just to make it enough simple, I will write it in the form of a table. So 8 values, so 8 columns, 4, 5, okay, the lines are not so straight, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8, so I'll write the numbers 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1 and 1, okay, now shift it, so the bits. Okay, so the bits will move one place towards the left, like this. It will move like this. So, this one will come here, like this. okay? So you have to write the numbers as it is. Just shift. Sorry, here it should be 1. 1 minute. Okay. So 4 ones and 0, 0, 0. See, I have written these numbers. Okay, what about this one then? This has moved out because there is no space. So, this will come back. It will come back here. So, 0. You have to move the bits based on the numbers that they have told here. So, here we have to, you know, shift it by 1. Sometimes we might have to shift it towards 2 places. So, then 2 bits have to be moved. Okay. So, that is how you will do. So, you have got this answer, that is 3 zeros followed by 4 ones, then a 0. Okay, now you know the answer is in the bit form, so binary form. So again you have to convert it into decimal. So convert into decimal. See, I am showing you step by step. Okay, if you can solve it at one stretch, it is fine. But you know, nobody should get confused how this step has come. So I am showing you step by step. Okay, so 0, 0. 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. Okay. So these are the values. Okay. Now you have to write the powers of 2. So 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64. And 128. Okay, now you see that the most significant bit is having the value, you know, as 0. So you are keeping 128 as it is. Okay. Okay. So what will be the answer here? So it would be 0 plus, this would be 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 0. Okay, now if you add, it would be 30. Okay, see what is the answer when you shift 15 one place towards the left, you will get the answer as 30. Okay, so when we are doing the left shift, you have to note that the numbers are getting doubled. See here, the question was 15. The question was 15 and you got the answer as 30. See, numbers have doubled. So, left shift means the numbers will double. Okay. Now, let me do the right shift. I will do the right shift here itself for 15. Because we already have the values here, right? So, I will take this itself. Okay. And remember, you have to, you know, carry out the same step. So, right shift. So, A is equal to 15. So, let's write. B is A. Right shift is this towards 1. So, you know the binary form. So, from step 1. From step 1, we are getting the answer as 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. 1, 1. You have to divide the numbers by 2. I have shown it, so I hope you know. Step 2. Step 2 is 1 minute. Okay, so what we will do is we will take that number. 8 places. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. We will write the numbers. Okay, now you have to move the bits towards the right like this. See, when you do that, okay, remember this, for example, let me show you here. Okay, so see here, this will come here, correct? So this will come here, so here, here, next bit. Then it would be 1, that is this one. Then it would be next one and next one. But what about this bit? There is no space for it. So it will come back here. So it is this. Okay. So that is how you will do it. Next is step 3. Step 3 is converting the number back to decimal. So you have the numbers like this. Okay, you know what to do. You have to write the powers of 2. So, 1, 2, sorry, then 4, 8, 16, 32, 64 and 128. But you see that the most significant bit is 1, so you will write minus sign. Now you will multiply and add. Minus 128 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 4. Okay. Plus 2 plus 1. Okay, so you have to multiply and add. Okay, so minus 20, you are getting the idea, right? So you will get the answer. Okay, so you have to multiply and add. Okay, so it is minus 128. So what is the answer? Okay, I hope you have understood the method, so you will be able to do it. So just multiply and let me know the answer. Okay, that is right shift operator. Then we have 3 more operators. One is AND operator, then there is OR operator, and there is XOR operator. So let me explain all 3 together. See here. Bitwise and 1 minute. Okay, so we have 3 more operators: bitwise and, bitwise OR and bitwise XOR. Okay, so the symbol for this is AND. For AND it is this, and for OR, and for it's a straight line, and for XOR it is this. Okay, so AND means, see AND. So when we have AND, we need 2 operands. Okay, for OR also, we are performing the OR on 2 operands. So for these 3 operations, that is AND, OR and XOR, we need 2 operators, 2 operands. See here, for example, let me show you with the help of an example. A is equal to, let A is equal to 55. Sorry, 1 minute. Okay. A is equal to, sorry, I'm having some difficulty with the screen. Just give me a second. That A is equal to 55 and B is equal to 45. Okay. Now we will do A and B, A or B, and we will do A or B. Okay, let's try to do these three operations. So the first step will be the same, that is you have to convert the number into binary. So by now you know you have to divide the numbers by, you know, what is that, divided by 2. So I will not do that step. I will assume that you have understood. Okay, so this 55 in binary would be 0, 0, okay, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, and 1. This is your binary number for 55. Like that, for 45 it is, for 45 it is 0, 0, then you have 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1. Okay, so these two are the numbers. These two are the numbers. Now let's do the AND operation on them. So the AND operation means, it is, you know, you have to explain it and make you remember it in very simple way. It is the multiplication of the two numbers, basically. That means you have a number, you multiply it by the other number. So here if you see, 1 and 1 is there. So you multiply. 1 and 1 is 1. That means both the inputs or both the numbers should be 1 for the answer to be 1. Otherwise it is 0. See, 1 times 0, 0. This is again 1. This is 0. This is 0. 1. 0 and 0. This is how you will get the answer. Likewise, if it is OR operation, if it is OR operation, that means either of the inputs should be 1. Either of the numbers should be 1. Remember this, okay. For AND, both the numbers should be 1. Okay. For OR, it is either of the numbers. So, 0, 0, okay, 1, 1, 0, 1. So it is, let me see, 0, 0, 1, sorry. Okay, let me write it again. Okay, 0, 0. 1 1 0 1 1 and 1, and our operation is 0, and the second number is 0 0 1 0 1 1. Okay, there is some issue with this screen. So, yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, like this. So, here, if I have to talk about this, so this is 1 and 1, so 1 itself. Then comes the next one. Notice very carefully, it is this, and the other number is this. So, 1 and 0 is 1. Then you have 1, then again 1, okay, again 1, and again 1. Then you have 0 and 0. Okay, similarly for XOR operation also. XOR operation is, okay, either, you know, if both the values are equal, then you will get the answer as 0. That means if you are doing the XOR of 0 and 0, you will get the answer as 0. And if you are doing the XOR of 1 and 1, you will get the answer as 0. Whereas if you are doing the XOR of 0 and 1 and 1 and 0, then you will get the answer as 1. See, for this same values, okay, it is 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, okay, 0, 1, 1, and 1. This is A and B is 0, 0, 1, 0 itself, sorry, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1. So let me correct this one. It looks a little messy, so yeah, this one let me erase it. Okay, let me write it again. So this would be 0. Okay, now XOR operation. XOR operation means both the inputs, if it is equal, then it is 1. 0. Sorry, here it is 0. Because both are 0. See, here also 0. Here also it is 0. Why it is 0 the third place? Because both are 1. Correct? So this value also would be 0. Okay. Then coming to the next place, this value would be 1 because values are unequal, A and B values. Here also it is 1. Then it is 1. Oh, sorry, it is 0. Here it is 0. There is some issue with the writing. And then we have 1. And this is 0. So you have to again convert this. These numbers that you have got are in the binary form, so you have to convert it. So let me convert one of them. Okay, so here I'll convert the result of the OR operation. So 2 to the power of 0, then you have 2 to the power of 1. Okay, 2 to the power of 1, then you have 2 to the power of 2. To the power of 3, 2 to the power of 4, and 2 to the power of 5. I'm not writing rest of the numbers because anyways they are, if you write also it is 0, it will be 64 and 128. So it is 32 plus 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1. Okay, so what will be the answer if you add all of this? If you add, so your answer would be, how much is it? Have you calculated already? The answer is going to be, the answer is going to be 60 63. The answer is going to be 63. Okay. So this is how you will do the operations. Okay. I'll give you one practice question. You solve it and tell me the answer. Okay. Let me give the practice question. You can put it in the comment box over there. Okay. So let me give the A value. Yes, 30. And B value as 20. B value is 20. Okay, you have to find A and B. Also find A or B. A or B. And find A or B. A and B, A or B, and A or B. You can send me the answer or you can write it in the comment box. Okay. These are the bitwise operators. Okay. So I hope it is clear. So let me show you here. Negate operator, left shift, right shift, and XOR and OR. So here also there is one example. If A is equal to 5, if I shift it, it becomes 10. Okay. And XOR also. Okay. Next we have special operators. In this we have some operators. See, these are the operators that do not come under the other section. So comma operator. So you can have like this. See, here you see sum is equal to A plus B, comma. That means you can write multiple statements in a single line. Okay. And size of operators. So you know the data types, right? Integer, float, character. So in order to find the size of a given a value, you can use this. See, if I write like size of char, then it is automatically 1 byte. Okay, int means 2, now not 2, it is 4 bytes. Float means 4, double is 8, like that. Okay, so here we have a program. See, I have written the program. See, I have given 4 variables. One is A, B, C, and the other one is name. So this is A. A is of the type integer, B is of the type float, C is of the type character. And D is a string. So if I give the size of, see in the program I have given size of. So first one, because it is integer, automatically it would take 2. Nowadays the new system, so it would be 4. Okay, 4 bytes. And float means 4. Character means 1. Here also character, but because it is having 10 values, so it is 1 into 10, that is 10 bytes. Okay, and we have this also. Let me quickly discuss unary, binary, and ternary operators. See, a kind of operator in which, you know, it will act only on one operand. So, for example, minus A or negate of A. All these are performing the operation on one operator, right? So, they are called as unary operators. Binary operators means the operator which performs operations on two operands, they are called as binary operators, A plus B. A or B, A and B, these come under binary operators. And ternary operator, an operator which acts on three operands to produce a result, is called as a ternary operator. So conditional operator comes under this. Okay, and this operator precedence chart, this is very, very important. Okay, you need to know the precedence. Okay, which one is having the higher precedence and how is the operation taking place also. Okay, so you can refer to this table. Okay, you need to remember Bodmas rule is the one which we use to, you know, which we use to get the precedence. But now we have some more operators, right? So we need to remember this. See here, plus plus, your postfix. You remember postfix? Okay, postfix, increment, postfix, decrement. Okay, prefix, all those comes, those are the operators which are higher precedence. Okay. And this one also, see here, when you have this arithmetic operation, see, these are the arithmetic operations. See here, s is equal to a plus b by plus c divided by 2. But we can't write it as a c, you can't write it as a c expression, right? I mean, you can't write it as it is, because this is not acceptable. See, this is how you would write. You will convert the expression into the form that is understood by the compiler. So we are dividing, see, we are showing the brackets, because otherwise the associativity might be lost. Okay, so here also there are some examples. So here sine divided by sine of b, so b here, divided by, it is square root of a square plus b square. So I have written, see, square root of a square, I have written as a star a plus b star b. Okay, some more examples are also there. You can find this in the notes that I've given, or also you can find it in the textbook also. Okay, so typecasting, I will show it in the next video. Or I think we can show it here itself, correct? I think I can show it here. See, when you have a variable and you have declared that variable in your program, for example, int of a, okay? It is used for storing an integer, int of a. And somewhere in the program, okay, that integer might have to get converted into float. So what you do is, you convert the data type of a from integer to float. And this process of converting the data type of a given variable from one type to another is called as type conversion. See the definition here. Type conversion or type casting of the variable refers to changing of a variable of one data type to another. Okay, and these are of two types. See, implicit and explicit. Implicit and explicit. What is the difference and how is it very helpful for us? Explicit means, okay, see the, before I go to this implicit and explicit, see this particular part where, you know, you see this ranking, see, it has a rank, see, character, okay, is having the least, you know, it is having the least precedence, sort of. Then, if it is int, see here, let me show this example too. See, int plus float is equal to float. See, I have given the int as 5. So look at the second example. Okay, integer as 5, float as 3.5. So 5 plus 3.5, how is it getting converted to 8.5? See, here before the conversion even, this 5 has got converted into 5.0. Why? Because you see in the chart, float is having the higher precedence. So compiler itself is converting the data type from integer to float. So based on this ranking, the compiler can convert the data type of a variable. So that is called as implicit. Okay, the compiler is doing it. Otherwise, you can convert it. Okay, so for example, I have a floating point number. For example, age of a person. So the person's age is 19 years old, and he is 19 years and 6 months old. So I will write 19.6. But then when I have to give the input, okay, somewhere like I have to fill out the life, this insurance form. That time I have to give the data in the form of an integer. That means I only need to give 19. I have input the value in the form of float, but I need to convert it into, you know, integer. If you do this using the compiler, if you think the compiler will do it, it will not, because integer is having lower precedence, right? So the values won't get converted from float to int. So if you want the values to get explicitly, that means you're forcing the variables to change the data type. So that is called as explicit. Okay, so the data type is something. Okay, for a type, it is of a type, and you are forcing it. If you are going against this ranking and you are converting explicitly, that is called as explicit conversion. Okay, both are having the advantages and disadvantages. For example, implicit means you don't have to worry about the conversion. The compiler will look at the ranking and it will convert it itself. Okay, And what is the advantage of explicit? Explicit means if you have a value which is of the lower data type, still you can convert it into higher. From higher to lower also you can do. Okay. So you have to learn the difference. You have to learn what it is. Okay. So in this video we have seen about bitwise operators, the operator precedence, special operators, and type conversion and type list. In the notes that I have provided, I have also given some more examples, so you can go through it. Okay, that's all for this video. Thank you.